So because of the anvaya of the vakya, the correlation of the whole section, which is called Maitri Brahmana, we find the subject matter that is dealt with here is Paramatma and not Vijnanatma or Jivatma. So yesterday we were reading the Siddhanta Paksha here on the page 330, Evam Prapte Brumaha. Various arguments were advanced to show why just a Pura Paksha, actually not a very strong Pura Paksha really, but still in order to clarify a certain point, this Pura Paksha is raised. In fact, there is one Pura Paksha towards the whole Adhikaranam here. So why is this there? Why the discussion here? Because everything seems to be very clear from Maitri Brahmana that this subject matter is Param Brahma. And therefore, there is no, we don't, for example, it is said, Tadevam Amrutattva Phalena Upakramat. Upakrama is Amrutattva Phalam. Because the question was, Yenaham Amrutanasyam Kim Tenaham Kuryamidi. What do I have to do with that with which I do not become immortal? Hadeva Bhagavan Veda, meaning Amrutattva Sadhanam Veda, whatever the revered sir knows as a means of immortality, may you please tell me. So, Amrutattva Phalena Upakramat. And so, Yajnavalkya proceeds to say that which is the means of Amrutattva immortality, because that was the question. So, in reference to that, the whole discourse is given. Madhyeja Atma Vijnanena Sarva Vijnanam Pratijnaya. Again, the Pratijna was Atma Vijnanena Sarva Vijnanam, that everything becomes known when the Atma is known. So, Drashtena Shrutya Matya Vijnanena Idam Sarvam Viditam Syat. So that way, by knowing the Atma, everything becomes known. Tat Upapadanat. And then all Upapadanam is done. As to how, when the general sounds are known, then the particular notes are also known, or the particulars cannot be perceived apart from the general or the universal. Similarly also, the creation cannot be perceived apart from consciousness, and therefore, nothing is apart from consciousness, everything is consciousness. Upasamhare cha mahatbhutam anandam ityadinam brahma rupa abhidhanat. Mahatbhutam anandam aparam vijnana ghana eva. So, upasamhara, in this manner also, there is also the anantam, aparam, vijnana, gaha, all of these are characteristics of Brahma. So, it is by knowing Brahman that one knows everything. So, knowing one, everything is known as a characteristic of Brahma. Amrutattva phalam, if the result is immortality, everybody knows that, that can be only when Brahma jnana is there. So, even the commencement by introduction by the immortality also is for Brahma, means it is the knowledge of Brahma, or it is Brahma subject matter. In between, when it is said that by knowledge of one that everything becomes known, that also makes it very clear that the subject matter is Brahma. At the end also, when it is said Anantam Aparam Vijnana Ghana, they are also characteristics of Brahma. So it is evident that this is, you know, this whole section discusses only Param Brahma.
Dvaitanandiyaja Advaita Guna Kirtanat.
We are reading yesterday, Advaita Nindya, Brahmatam Paradat, Yahanyatra Atmanam Brahma Veda. So Brahma means Brahmana actually rejects this fellow. If Brahmana feels that this fellow looks upon me as different from himself, so that's Advaita Nindya.
Advaita Guna Kirtanat.
And Advaita Guna Kirtanam, so Advaita Nindya and Advaita Guna Kirtanam. So Kirtanam, singing the gunas of Advaita.
Brahmaiva Maitreyi Brahmane Pratipadyam Na Jivatmaiti.
So it is very clear that Maitreyi Brahmane Brahmaiva Pratipadyam. It is Brahman that is taught or instructed in Maitreyi Brahmana and nothing else, not Jivatma.
Iti Nasti Purupaksha Iti.
So where is the question of Purupaksha? Why in fact?
Iti Anarabhyamevidam Adhikaranam.
There is a Purupaksha towards the whole Adhikaranam. So why are you even starting the discussion? Because we don't find any scope of this question. The Adhikaranam, the whole discussion topic is started because there is a doubt whether Maitri Brahmana subject matter is Jivatma or Paramatma. It says it is very clear that it is Brahma or Paramatma. So why commence the discussion? Anyway, that question will be answered as to why. But the idea is that in fact the subject matter of Maitri Brahmana is fairly clear. And therefore there is even a question as to whether this Adhikaranam has any place or not. It does have a place.
So on the page 330, Bhashyakara said, Paramatma Upadesha Hevayam, in the fourth line, Evam Prapte Brumaha.
When on the strength of the Upakrama, the Purupakshi says that the because Atmanastu Kamaya Saram Priyam Bhavati, where Atma is presented as that which is the object of love, and for whom this Pati Jayadikam is all Bhogijadam, so Atma is presented as the one who enjoys all this, and locus of enjoyment, so is the Bhokta, and so the Purupakshi says Upakrama begins with Atma the Bhokta. In between also Drashtavya, Atmavara Drashtavya, where Atma is again presented as the, that which one should be known. And Etebhya Bhutebhya Samuttaya, the one that gains a Jiva Bhava on account of identification of the Bhutas, means the Karyakarana Sangada, that also pertains to Jivatma. Vijñātāramare kena vijāniyāt, when again the subject matter is presented as Vijñātā, meaning Vijñānakarta, that also shows his Vijñānātma. So Purupakshi finds enough reasons to say that there is a doubt in our mind as to whether the subject matter is Jivatma or Paramatma. Evam prapte brumah, we say that it is Jivatma. And so the Siddhanta is presented, Paramatma upadesha evayam. In fact, this is the upadesha of Paramatma. Kasmat vakyanvaya, because the whole vakya of the passage, only adanvaya, has correlation with reference to Brahma. Vakyam idam pova pariyana vekshamanam paramatmanam pati anvitavayam lakshade. Then the various avayava, the various sections of this whole Brahmana, all of them correlate with Paramatma when we analyze them with reference to purva and apara. So what precedes and what follows with reference to what we may call the Shadlinga for Tatpara Nishaya, so Upakrama Upasamhara. So when you apply this Tatpara, the Linga for the Tatpara Nishaya, becomes very clear to us that the subject matter is Brahma. Kathamiri, how do you say that the different sections actually correlate with Brahma? Tat Upapadyate, that is being said here with reasoning. Amrutatvasiduna Shasti Vittenidi Yajnavalkyat Upashrutya. So when Maitri heard from Yajnavalkya that Amrutattvam or immortality cannot be attained with wealth, meaning with karma, Yenaham Namrutasyam Kimaham Tena Kuryamidi, and she said that, what do I have to do with that? I wish I do not become immortal. Yadeva Bhagavan Veda Tadeva Me Bruhi. So whatever the sir, revered sir knows as the means of immortality, may you please tell me that. Idi Amrutattvam Ashasanaya Maitreya Yajnavalkya Atma Vijnanam Idam Upadishadi. And so Maitreya, who is keenly desirous of the immortality, the means of immortality, to Maitreya suggests that Yajnavalkya has given this Upadesha. Meaning that means that the Upadesha of Yajnavalkya is definitely a means of immortality, because that is precisely what Maitreya wanted and nothing else. Nasa Anyatra Paramatma Vijnanat Amrutattvam Asti Iti Shruti Smriti Vadaha Vadanti. Everywhere we find the Shruti and the Smriti, that immortality can be attained only by Paramatma Jnanam and never by Jivatma Jnanam. Tathacha Atma Vijnanena Sarva Vijnanam Uchyamanam Na Anyatra Paramakarana Vijnanat Mukhyam Avakalpade. Also by knowledge of Atma that everything is known, that is only possible when the Atma that we are talking about is Mukhya Karanam, is the ultimate material cause of the creation. Then alone this pratijna can be fulfilled by that, by knowing the Atma, that everything can be known. And so it's not, there's no way that by knowing Jivatma that one knows everything. Although Purupakshi said that this can be taken in the secondary sense, that Jivatma is a bhokta and the whole world is this the object of enjoyment for him. In that sense it is said that when you know the bhokta, the bhogya also is known. Nasayat Aupacharikam Ashraidum Shakyam. And also it is not possible that you can just take this to be not to be taken literally. So don't take this literally, that knowing one, knowing the Atma, everything becomes known. Just take it in a figurative sense. Since that's not possible. Yat karanam atma vijnane asar vijnanam pratinyaya anantarena granthena tadeva upapadayati. Because having made the pratijna proposition that by knowing the Atma everything becomes known, then the Shruti you say Yajnavalkya proceeds to show it logically how it is that by knowing the Atma everything becomes known. And so that pratignya or that proposition is fulfilled, lovered. Therefore we say that it is meant so that by knowing the Atma, everything becomes known is to be taken literally, because the Shruti proceeds to show that in a logical manner.
Brahmatam paradat. Now this is what we were reading yesterday. Brahmatam paradat ihanyatra atmana brahma veda ityadina. Yataha says Bhamadi on the page 329, if you are interested in third line. Yataha brahmatam paradat brahmana jatihi brahmanoham ityam abhimana ityavada. Brahmatam paradat. Ihanyatra atmanam brahma veda. Atmaha brahma veda. So one knows the Atma. So one knows Brahmana is different from Atma. So one looks upon Brahmana is different from the self. That person who has this kind of a wrong perception is one that is actually rejected by Brahmana. Meaning that he is deviated from the Paramapurushada, from the ultimate goal of his life. That's what Bhavadikara also explains. Brahma means Brahmana jatihi. Brahmanaham iti evam abhimana iti avata. Brahma means the one who knows oneself is Brahmana. Tam paradat, parakuryat, amrutatva padat. So this Brahmana, he actually rejects this fellow, deviates this fellow from his means for his goal of immortality. Kam whom? Iha nyatra atmanah Brahma, Brahmana jati veda. Who is the one that is thus deviated from the goal? One looks upon a Brahmana as different from himself. As we were discussing there in the course of the discussion of the text, as to how whenever the duality is created, that there is a sense, other person knows that I am being looked upon as different. And that very sense of duality, the very sense of division that is felt by the other person, and then you are also made to feel that. And that division itself is denial of immortality. In fact, every experience could lead to immortality. Every experience can bring about immortality. Wow. Inasmuch as whenever there is non-duality, there is immortality. However, that experience of immortality I am denied whenever there is a duality or division. And so this is what is meant by parada, that one is actually denied, or one is deprived of one's goal or one's true nature of immortality. That every experience in fact can be an experience of immortality. That one is denied. Otherwise I don't have to look for immortality. That's what there is. But I am denied that immortality by that very perception of duality when I look upon the other person as different from me. So other person stands in contradiction to me, thereby making me experience only a sense of isolation, and that is our deprivation of immortality. This is what is meant by paradat, parakuryat. Evam kshatriyadishavi drashtavyam. Similarly also, kshatram tam paradat yaha nyatra atmanah kshatram veda. And so the kshatriya also rejects this fellow, deprives him of his goal, of his true nature, of the benefit that the life should have. He is denied. The benefit of life is to be able to experience immortality all the time, because that's the truth. And that one is denied only because of this vision of duality. Atma eva jagadha tattvam natu tadadriktam kinchit tadidi. Atma eva jagadha tattvam. The idea is that Atma, the myself, is the tattvam, the truth of the entire creation. Meaning the I, the Atma, and the self of the entire creation. Na tadadriktam kinchit asti. There is no tattvam other than the Atma. Satraiva bhagavati shrutihi upattim drashtanta prabandhenaha. There also Bhagavati Shruti Dushtanta Prabandhena Upattimaha. As to how Atma is the Tattvam, how the Atma is the truth of the entire creation, there is no Tattvam or truth other than Atma, that Shruti actually gives by a whole range of Dushtantam. Dushtanta Prabandha. That means a whole range of illustrations. Different illustrations were given. Illustration of a drum, illustration of a conch, illustration of a lute. Upattim aha. So Bhagavati Shruti, see how they mention this. Atreva Bhagavati Shruti. So Shruti is Bhagavati. So you can see what an amount of reverence is. Great people. These are not ordinary people at all. They themselves are so great,
But there was such a great reverence for the Shruti, for the teachers, for that whole tradition, for God. So Upapatti, Shruti herself obliges us by giving us the reason as to why the truth of the whole creation is Atma.
Yat khalu yat graham vina na shakyate grahidum tat tataha na vyatirichyate.
This is the rule. See, they don't have to repeat anybody's sentence. This thing just flows from them, you know. So this language and this expression simply flows effortlessly.
Yat khalu yat graham vina na shakyate grahidum.
That which cannot be perceived apart from the other one,
tat tataha na vyatirichyate.
That one is definitely not different from the other. If one thing cannot be perceived apart from the other one, then this one thing is not different from the other one.
Yatha rajatam shuktikayaha.
We give the example of gold in the ornaments cannot be perceived apart from gold, therefore the ornaments are nothing but gold. But Vedanta is always preferred to give this ultimate example.
Yatha rajatam shuktikayaha vina grahitum na shakyate.
Just as no one can perceive that silver without the mother of pearl, at least the... So, idam rajatam, when we say that idam amsha belongs to Shuktika,
bhujangova rajyohu vina na grahitum shakyate,
nor is it possible to perceive the bhujanga or the snake without the rope. Again, when we say ayam sarpaha, that ayam amsha belongs to the rajju.
Dundubhyari shabda samanyadva tat shabda bhedana grihyande shabda bhedana grihitum shakyande.
And similarly also, dundubhyari shabda samanyadva, and apart from the samanya or the general sound of dundubhi, it is not possible to hear the particular notes of dundubhi. And therefore, what we call the particular notes of dundubhi are really not separate from the general note. And therefore, it is a general note or even general sound that is the truth of all the notes emanating from dundubhi on a drum.
Nagruhyande chidrupa graham vina sthitikale nama rupani.
And nagruhyande cha chidrupa graham vina sthitikale nama rupani. Nama rupani cha sthitikale chidrupa vina nagruhyande. And similarly also names and forms also cannot be perceived at the time of their existence, so names and forms cannot be perceived apart from consciousness.
Tasmat na chidatmanah bhidyante.
So just as the particular notes are not different from the general notes, also every name and form is not separate from chidatma, chidrupam, consciousness, because without consciousness no name and form can be perceived.
Tad idam uktam,
and that is what is being said.
Sayatha dundubhe hanyamanasyeti.
And so that is how all these various examples are given.
Dundubhe grahanena tadgadam shabda samanyam upalakshayati. Dundubhe hanyamanasya.
When a drum is beaten, that time bahyan shabdam na shakyate grahidum. It is not possible to actually perceive or hear the bahya shabda, meaning the particular sounds.
And the dundubhe grahanena tadgatam shabda samanyam upalakshayati.
So by the word dundubhi or the drum, we understand the general sound of the drum. And that's already shown how sthitikale, at the time of existence. So the example of dundubhi and the shankha and the veena are meant to show how sthitikale, at the time of existence, that the creation is not different from consciousness.
Na kevalam sthitikale naam roopa prapanchah chidatma atirekena agrahana chidatmanah na vyatirichyate.
Na kevalam sthitikale is not only at the time of the existence.
Naam roopa prapanchah chidatma atirekena agrahana.
Then this whole prapancha of name and form, not since this prapancha consisting of name and form cannot be perceived other than consciousness, and therefore that is the time of existence, the prapancha or the creation is a consciousness.
Apitu namarubotpattehe pragavi chidrupavasthanat.
Not only that, but even before the creation, even before the emergence of the creation consisting of name and form, even before the emergence also, it is not apart from consciousness.
Chidrupavasthanat.
tat upadanatvacha. So what happens is, whatever a thing is before its creation, that is its material cause. For example, all the parts, whatever they are before their creation, they are clay. So clay is the material cause. Or whatever the ornaments are before their creation becomes the material cause. And similarly also, if this whole creation of name and form, before its creation is consciousness, then consciousness is the material cause. And so, chidrupavasthanat tad upadanat upadanatvacha nāgurūva prapañcasya tad anatirekah. Therefore we say that, even before the creation also, this whole prapancha of names and forms is nothing but consciousness. How? Rajya upadanasyeva bhujangasya rajyo anatirekah iti. Shruti apparently didn't know this Rajju sarpa dushtanda etc. Therefore, they are giving different dushtanda. But anyway, the teachers are always correlate. Rajju upadanasyeva bhujangasya. Like bhujanga, the snake, which is Rajju, the rope, is the material cause. So why the snake before its creation? Rajju. So Rajju is the material cause of the snake. Rajju ho anatirekah iti. Iti eda dushtantena sadhayati bhagavati shrutihi. So why again another dushtanta, Shruti tells us how the whole creation is consciousness before its emergence also. And therefore also it is consciousness alone. So yatha adraidhognehe abhyetasya prathakdhumaha vinishchirandi evam varasya mahadabhutasya nishvasidam edadya drugvedaha ityadina chaturvidho mantra uktaha. So yatha ardhaidha agnehe. So just as the fire that is lit from moist or wet fuel, abhihidasya, when it's kindled, prathadhumaha vinischarandi, how you find the smokes and the sparks and the ember and flames, all of them emerge from the fire when it is lit from wet fuel. And the idea there is that what we call the flames and the embers and the sparks and the smoke etc. not apart from the fire, because that's what they were before their creation. Evam vāryasya mahato bhūtasya nishvasitam edadya drugvedaha. Similarly also, hey Maitreyi, what we call drugveda, yajurveda, samaveda, atharaveda, itihasa, puranam, all of this is nothing but in fact mahato bhūtasya. All of these has emerged from this great reality. And therefore, all of these are not but nothing but the great reality. Nishvasitam. Also, all of them emerge effortlessly. Just as a smoke, etc. emerge from the fire effortlessly. So also, Rig Veda and all of these Vedas have emerged from the God, from the Lord, emerged effortlessly. So Rig Veda ityadina chaturvidho mantra uktaha. My Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Samaveda, Atharaveda, the Shruti meant the fourfold mantra. And Itihasa, Puranam, by all of that is meant the Ashtavidam Brahmanam. Itihasa Ityadina Ashtavidam Brahmanam Uktam. In short, the Shruti says that the whole Vedas consisting of mantra and Brahmana is emerged from the Lord. Like the out-breath emerges from a person. Eduttam bhavati yatha agnimatram prathamam avagamyate kshudranam visvalinganam upadanam. Just as all little sparks which have darted and emerged from the fire, what do we understand is that all the sparks are nothing but the fire before, because that's what they were before their emergence. So agnimatram prathamam avagamyate kshudranam visvalinganam upadanam. So the dushtanta is very clear that all these tiny sparks are nothing but the fire. Fire is the material cause of the sparks. Atha tataha visvalingaha vicharandi. That's the reason why the sparks emerge from the fire, because fire is the material cause of the sparks. Nachayate agnehe tatvannitva bhyam shakyande nirvaktum. It is not possible to determine. So what is the relationship between fire and the spark? So what is the truth of the spark with reference to fire?
Agnehe tattva anyatva bhyam sakyare na nirvaktum.
It is not possible for us to say that the spark is fire. Nor it is possible for us to say that so spark is non-separate from fire. Nor is possible for us to say that spark is separate from fire. If spark were separate from fire, then it need not emerge from fire. It can emerge independently, but it is not the case. Therefore, we cannot say it is separate. Nor can we say the spark is fire, because then we won't call it spark, because it does possess certain kind of peculiarity. And so spark is mithya. Mithya is there, which never stands apart from satyam. In that sense, we say that the truth of the spark is nothing but fire.
Evam rugvedavayopi alpa prayatna brahman vicharandah na tatah tattvanyatva bhyam niruchare.
And so also the Vedas, consisting of mantra and brahman, also cannot be said to be apart from brahman, because they emerge from brahman effortlessly.
Rugadivihi naam upalakshare.
So by the word rugveda, yajurveda and ashtavidam brahmana, what we understand is all the sounds. So Veda is said to be sarvajna, and therefore Vedas contain whatever there is to be known. And so when it is said that the Vedas have emerged from the Lord, meaning all the sound and all the names have emerged from the Lord.
Rugadivihi naam upalakshare. Yadacha namadhyasya iyam gadihi tadatat purvakasya rupadhyasya kayeva kathayati bhavaha.
Yadacha, just to read itself is so pleasant, you know, his language is so beautiful.
Yadacha namadhyasya iyam gatihi.
If the nam, what is called by a name, so that is a gati, meaning if the name is emerged from the Lord and therefore not apart from the Lord, then what talk of rupa, which depends upon nama?
Tat purvakasya nama purvakasya rupa dhyasya kayeva katha.
Then what to talk of the rupa, which itself is derived from the nama, so that the rupa also is emerged from the Lord, what to talk of that? That means the whole universe consisting of name and form has emerged from the Lord.
Na kevalam tad upadanatvat tadaha na vidirichyate na rupa prapanchaha.
Alright. It is not just because Brahma is the upadana karanam for the prapancha of the name and form, and therefore the prapancha is not separate from Brahma. All of this is upapatti. All of this is the reason that is presented to make a point as to how by knowing Brahma that everything is known, because Brahma is chidrupam, Brahma is of the nature of consciousness, and that the whole universe is not apart from consciousness, so universe is consciousness. Therefore, having known consciousness itself, one has known everything. So to establish that, all these illustrations are being given.
Na kevalam tadupadanatvat tataha na vidirchyate naam rupa prapanchaha.
Then this prapancha of name and form is not separate from Brahman, just because Brahman is the upadana karanam.
Pralaya samaye tucha tad anupravesha tato na vidirchyate.
Even at time of pralaya also, that because the prapancha ultimately gets merged, it emerges from Brahman and it merges also in Brahman. Therefore also we say that prapancha is not separate. So at the before creation, at the time of sustenance, and also in the state of merger, the universe or the creation is never apart from Brahman, which is Chidrupam.
So pralaya samayecha tad anupraveshat tataha nivyatirichyate. Sayatha sarvasam apam samudraheka evayanam evam sarvesham sparshanam tvageka ayanam evam sarvesham gandhanam nasikeka ayanam evam sarvesham rasanam jihvaeka ayanam evam sarvesham rupanam chakshureka ayanam evam sarvesham shabdanam srotrameka ayanam evam sarvesham sankalpanam maneka ayanam evam sarvasam vidyanam hrudayameka ayanam evam sarvesham Karmanam hastavekayanam, evam sarvesham anandanam upasthekayanam, sarvesham visarganam payarekayanam, evam sarvesham adhvanam paduvekayanam, evam sarvesham vedanam vagekayanam.
All of this merger. The example of merger was given. How the samudra, the ocean is ayanam, the ultimate abode, the merger, place of merger. becoming one, that how all the streams of water become one when they reach the samudra or the ocean.
So says the Bhavadikara, yatha samudrameva ambha. And then further, even the other,
then the further example is, of course, the example of Sesha Sindhavakilya, Udake Prastha, Udakameva Anuvilyeta, Nahasya Udgrahanaya Ivasyat.
So here also the Bhavadikara explains that Yatha Samudrameva Ambha, Samudrameva Ambha, Prithvi Te Samparkat Kahinyam Vagadam Sindhavam Kilya, Samudram Ambha, just as the ocean, water of the ocean.
Prithvi Teja Sambarkat, that water of the ocean, because of the contact with the earth as well as with the fire or the heat rather,
Kathinyam Upagaram Sindhavam Khilyaha,
it attains the state of that water, attains the state of hardness and becomes a lump.
Sahi Swakare Samudre Kshiptaha Ambhaeva Bhavati.
And that same khilya or the lump, so akare samudre, when it is dropped into samudra, the ocean, which is its own origin, you know, so akara. So from where it has come ultimately, and therefore when it is dropped into samudra, the ocean, which is its the source,
ambhaeva bhavati,
how that lump becomes ambha, water itself, which is what it was to begin with.
Evam chidam bhodau linam jagat chideva bhavati.
And similarly also, the entire creation merges into chin, chit or consciousness.
Chidam bhodau linam.
So whole jagat at the time of dissolution merges into the ocean of consciousness. And therefore we say that it is nothing but consciousness.
Nadu tataha atirichyateiti.
That it is not separate from chit or awareness.
Eta drishtanta prabandhenaha,
all of this is illustrated by a number of drishtanta,
sayatha sarvasam apam ityadi.
Drishtanta prabandhamuktva dashtantike yojayati, having told the whole group of drishtanta prabandha, then dashtantike yojayati, that drishtanta is now shown, its application is shown to dashtanta, meaning to atma.
Ivam vāyidam mahadbhūtam anantam apāram vijñāna gaha eva.
Similarly, hey Maitre, ivam vāre mahadbhūtam idam mahadbhūtam anantam apāram vijñāna gaha eva.
Hey Maitre, similarly also, this mahadbhūtam, the whole universe is nothing but mahadbhūtam, this great reality, which is vijñāna gaha anantam apāram.
So in fact, mahadbhūtam, Mahat is big or great.
So, Bruhatvena Brahma Uktam.
By Mahat we should understand that which is great or limitless, meaning Brahma.
Idam Brahma, Idam Mahat Bhutam, this Brahma.
Is Mahat, Idam Mahat Bhutam, that's how Bhavadikara seeks to explain.
Mahat Chetat Bhutam Cha Mahat Bhutam, that's how Vashyakara explained.
Idam Mahat Bhutam, where Mahat Bhutam was taken as one compound word.
Here Bhavadikara, Idam Mahat Bhutam.
So Mahat and Bhutam are taken as separate words.
Idam Mahat Bhutam.
Idam Mahat. What is Mahat? Mahat means great, big, meaning Brahma.
Idam Brahma Bhutam.
Bhutam means what?
Reality, Satyam.
So Idam Brahma Bhutam meaning Satyam.
Hey Maitre, similarly this Brahma is Satyam.
Anantam Nityam.
Aparam Sarvagatam.
Vijnana ghana, vijnana ikarasa
hityavata. That it is vijnana ikarasa, is pure awareness.
Etebhya bhutebhya samuthaya, says Mahamati.
Etebhya karyakarana bhavena vyasthitebhya bhutebhya samuthaya
samya, samyak uthaya, samyena uthaya.
So samuthaya, that prefix sam is interpreted as samyena uthaya.
So this Brahma identifying with this Karyakarana Sanghata made of the five elements and becomes like them. Samyena Uthaya.
So this Karyakarana Sanghata made of five elements, when it is born,
Samyena Uthaya, then Brahma also is born.
So birth of Brahma also is similar to, or Brahma also gets born
just as the five elements get born because of the identification. Idea is that this Paramatma, because of identification with the Upadhi, made up of five elements, also is born along with them and dies along with them as well.
Karyakara Sanghadasya hi avachedari dukkhitva shokitvadaya tad avachinne chidatmani tad viparite pratiyande yatha udakabimba pratimbe bimbide chandramasi toyegata kambadaya.
Karyakara, see, the nice thing about him is actually supposedly writing commentary on Bhashya, but it is an independent commentary, sort of. But at the same time makes it a point to refer always be centered upon Bhashya. So the illustrations that he gives also are taken from Bhashya. So like Yatha Udaka Pratimbide Chandramasi. So while remaining committed to Bhashya, he exercises an adequate independence of freedom also. Other Tikakaras are totally committed to Bhashya and therefore very rarely they exercise any freedom. They just explain the Bhashya. Here, while being committed to Bhashya, he has sufficient freedom to explain the things in his own way, to highlight Bhashya or to bring out points which are required and whatever, or to give the meanings which are somewhat different or different shades of meaning in order to enhance certain points. So all that freedom Bhavadikara has, or he assumes, let us say.
Karyakara Sanghadasya hi,
or Karyakara Sanghada, the Sanghada consisting of gross and subtle bodies.
Avachedat dukkhitva shokitvadaya.
This poor Karyakara Sanghada, avachedat, because it is limited. Limited in time, limited in space, it being limited.
Therefore dukkhitva shokitvadaya.
Therefore dukkhitvam shokitvam. Therefore this Sanghada is dukkhi as well as shokagrastha. It is dukkhi and happy as well as sad. Why? Because of avachedha limitation.
Tad avachinne chidatmani tad viparite pratiyante.
And therefore the dukkha, shoka, etc., which are the nature of the Sanghada, they appear to be in the Atma or Brahman, which is actually Chidatma. In fact, not limited in its own nature, but appears to be as though limited because of identification with Upadhi. And therefore, the Dukkhitvam, Shokitvam, etc., which is there in the Upadhi, appears in Chidatma.
Yatha Udaka Pratibimbide Chandramasi Toyegataha Kampadaya.
Just as in the east, moon that is reflected in the water, how the reflection also appears to be shaking.
Toyegataha Kampadaya.
Toy means water. So kampa means chalanam. And so the shaking or the movement, which actually belongs to the water, how it appears to be in the reflected moon. It appears, in fact, even the reflection does not move. It looks to us as though the reflection moves. Reflection also does not move. But automatically, the surface movement of the water, it creates an optical illusion and we automatically superimpose that upon the reflection. And we think that the reflection is moving.
Tadidam samyena uttanam.
What is meant by samuttaya? This is called samyena uttanam. Just as the reflection of the moon is shaking sympathetically, in sympathy with the shaking of the water. This is samyena uttanam. Sympathetic, reaction. And so also the Chiratma, who is identified with this Karyakarana Sanghata, made up of five elements, seems to be sympathetically undergoing the same kind of reaction. That when this Sanghata is born, that the Paramatma also is born, and when this Sanghata dies, that Paramatma also dies. Just as the reflection of the moon appears to be shaking when the water is shaking, and it's dull when the water is dull, and so forth.
Taridam samyena uttanam.
So in a very brief but a brilliant manner, how the whole Brahma is explained.
Yadatu,
and also fills in the blanks in between wherever necessary.
Agamacharya upadesha purvaka manana nidhyasana prakarsha paryantaja asya brahma swarupa sakshatkara upavartate tada nimrushta నిఖిలవాసనా విద్యామరస్య కార్యకారణ సంఘాతభూతస్య వినాశే తానివ భూతాని నశ్యంతి నశ్యంతి అను తదుపాధి చిరాత్మనః ఖిల్యభావః నశ్యతి.
యదాతు అండ్ ఆల్ రైట్ దిస్ చిరాత్మ హ్యాస్ అరైజన్ హీస్ బోర్న్ ఇన్ సింపతి ఆర్ ఇన్ అకార్డెన్స్ విత్ ది బర్త్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఫైవ్ ఎలిమెంట్స్ విచ్ మేక్ అప్ దిస్ ఉపాధి అండ్ దిస్ గోస్ ఆన్ ఫ్రమ్ టైమ్ బిగినింగ్ లెస్
యదాతు వెన్ హౌ ఎవర్ ఆగమ ఆచార్య ఉపదేశపూర్వక మనన నిధ్యాసన ప్రకర్ష పర్యంత అస్య బ్రహ్మస్వరూప సాక్షాత్కార ఉపావర్తతే. స్వస్య ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఫెలో బ్రహ్మస్వరూప సాక్షాత్కార ఆఫ్ దిస్ జిజ్ఞాసు సాక్షాత్కార ద రియలైజేషన్ రియలైజేషన్ ఇస్ ద వెరీ సెల్ఫ్ బ్రహ్మస్వరూప సాక్షాత్కార ఉపావర్తతే. వెన్ ఇస్ జిజ్ఞాసు కమ్స్ టు నో ద సెల్ఫ్ ఇస్ బ్రహ్మన్ ఇమీడియట్లీ హౌ మనన నిధ్యాసన ప్రకర్ష పర్యంత when that mananam and nididhyasanam attains an excellence. But where, what is the mananam nididhyasanam? Agama acharya upadesha purvaka. That mananam and nididhyasanam which is preceded by the upadesha of the acharya, which is based on agama. So by, on account, because of preceded by the instruction of the teacher, based on the scriptures, when the mananam and nididhyasanam performed by the jignyasu attained excellence, then they culminated into what we call brahma sakshatkara or the realization of Brahman as the very self.
Tada nirmushta nikhila savasana avidyamalasya karyakana sanghata bhutasya vinashe.
This karyakana sanghata, meaning here khilya bhava, the jiva bhava actually. The one that gets destroyed is what? Jiva bhava. What is the jiva bhava? The jiva bhava is the state attained because of identification with this karyakarana sanghata. And by the strength of the knowledge, nahi jnanena sadusham pavitra mihi vidyate, that knowledge actually purifies everything. There is no purifier like knowledge. So therefore, in the wake of the knowledge, when the purification takes place, sida tada nirmushta nikhila vasana avidyamalasya, that is jiva, who was so far polluted by the mala, the impurity of the vasana and avidya. So ignorance and all the vasanas, meaning all the notions which are born of ignorance, the one who was polluted or contaminated by that. Nimushta, when all these contamination of the nature of ignorance and the various notions arising from them, all of that is in fact wiped away, swept away by the knowledge.
Taniya bhutani nashyanti anu taniya bhutani nashyanti. Nashyanti is not kriyapada actually. Taniya bhutani nashyanti, when these bhutas are actually dying, meaning, so when the identification of bhuta, the elements is gone, anu, and following that, tadupadehi chidatmanaha khilyabhava vinashyati, then తదుపాధి చిదాత్మన ఖిల్యభావ తదుపాధి ఖిల్యభావ దట్ ఖిల్యభావ ద సెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇండివిజువాలిటీ విచ్ వాజ్ ఆన్ అకౌంట్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ కార్యకరణ సంఘాత దట్ ఖిల్యభావ ద సెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇండివిజువాలిటీ ఆల్సో ఇస్ డిస్పెల్ ఇన్ ఫాలోయింగ్ ద డిస్పెల్లింగ్ ఆఫ్ ది ఖిల్యభావ ఐడెంటిఫికేషన్ విత్ దిస్ ఉపాధి. So it was said, etebhyah bhutebhyah samutthaya taneva anvinashyati na pretya sanyasti. So says Mahamadikara, na tataha na pretya. So this pretya can be understood both ways. Pretya means having departed. It means death, physical death of the body, or before that it should really mean the death of the ego, which is in wake of the knowledge of brahmajnanam. Tataha na pretya, meaning karyakaranabhutanivrutto rupagandhadi sanyasti. So here sanya is very clearly stated, rupagandhadi sanyasti. Then that consciousness does not have any particular sanya, does not have particular consciousness of the form and color and stuff like that, which is there in the state of ignorance. So following that, yatra tu dvaitamaya bhavati itara itaram jagrati itara itaram pashyati. So jigrati, pashyati, shrunoti, abhivadati, all of these particular consciousness is there only in the realm of duality, which is there as long as ignorance is.
Na pretya kari karana bhutani vrittau.
So pretya means departed. So after departure, for the wise man. So, yatra tu asya sarvam atma eva bhut, yatra asya sarvam atma eva bhut, tat kenakam jigret. Then for this wise man everything has become atma, then what will he smell with what? So this kind of sanya, meaning the particular consciousness is no more there for the wise man, or is no more there in the chidachit, meaning consciousness. Then says, na preti sanya asti sanyamatra nishedat atmana siddhamanyamana samaitrei hovacha. Na preti sanyasti, that having departed there is no consciousness. It is sanyamatra nishedat, sanyamatra nishedat. Thus in atma the sanya, the consciousness altogether is as though denied. Na preti sanyasti, therefore it appears as though the consciousness itself is denied in atma after preti or death. Therefore atmanasti. So it is manyamana maitrei. So maitrei, who thought that what is meant is that existence of atma itself does not remain after death. So when it was said that the consciousness no more remains after death, then prajnana gana or vijnana gana, atma is consciousness. So consciousness is not there, atma itself does not remain after death, or atma itself does not remain after the dispelling of this identification. That's what Maitreya thought was meant by Yajnavalkya. Atreya ma bhagavan amu muhat. So that's what Maitreya say. Saho vacha Maitreya. Atreya ma bhagavan amu muhat. Na pretya sanya asti di. So when Bhagavan says pretya sanya nasti, then I have been thrown into confusion. So mohitavan na pretya sanyasti, that I am totally thrown into confusion when you say that there is no consciousness. Saho vacha yajnavalkya hai. Na vareham moham bravimi alam varedam vijnanaya. Saho vacha yajnavalkya hai. Yajnavalkya who was thus told said. So abhiprayam vacha. Yajnavalkya then said his own abhipraya. So what actually he intended by saying na pretya sanyasi, this is what Yajnavalkya said in response to Maitreya's question. Dvaitehi rupadi vishesh sanyari bandhano dukkhitvadi abhimanah. He Maitreya, what I meant is, dvaitehi, as long as one looks upon the world as separate from the atma, that means as long as one thinks that the atma is confined to this karyakarana sanghata, rupadi vishesh sanya nibandhano hi dukkhitvad abhimana, then all there is abhimana, there is conclusion that I am dukkhi, I am sukhi, and all this abhimana, all these conclusions about oneself that I am happy and happy, I am sad and whatever, all of this is rupadi vishesh sanya nibandhano. It's interesting that moment any kind of a role is assumed by me, there is no dukkha. Because associated with every role there are problems. There is no role that is free from problem. So moment this person becomes aware that I am father, his blood pressure rises. Because moment he becomes aware that I am father, he remembers his son. And who is your son? This fellow is 6 feet 3 inches tall, 195 pounds, you know, weight, riding his motorbike with his shirt not buttoned, you know, and exhibiting the mana that is given by his mother. You know, this fellow is going. Moment the father sings your son like that, his blood pressure rises, you know. So similarly, even when you say, I am a smeller, I am a seer, I am a hearer. A hearer, seer, smeller, thinker, knower, all of them are problems. In fact, all my problems arise because I know something. Or I think something, or I see something, or I hear something, or I smell something. And people smell whether it's there or not, but anyway. And so moment I smell something, problem. I see something, problem. Swamiji, I somehow perceive everything. So some people see problems everywhere, you know. So that nothing can ever escape me, you know, they say. I guess so. But anyway, so moment there is a role that I am a seer, I am a hearer, I am a perceiver, I am a smeller, or I am a thinker, I am a knower, I am a man, I am a woman, I am a father, I am a mother. Dukkhitvada abhimana, immediately, so says Bhamadikar, rupad visheshanya nibandhana. Even visheshanya, particular knowledge, that this is a form or a color. When I proclaim this to be a color, separate from me, the knower, then I automatically become the knower of the color, knower of the form. This is not a problem. Why should that be a problem? Because the moment this form or color is separate from me, it is going to be judged by me. As what? As very beautiful, as not so beautiful, as likable, as dislikable, and what? So what's the problem if you say it is beautiful? But this is said to be beautiful only in reference to something which is said to be ugly anyway. And therefore, the fact that this is called beautiful is in contrast to something that is ugly. And therefore, there is a potential problem, put it this way. When I appreciate this as beautiful, at that moment, there is no evident problem, but potential problem is there, because when I turn my side elsewhere, I see something ugly. Or I judge that as ugly in reference to this, because I see that color as different from this color. Yatrudha dvaitamiva bhavati. So when I look upon this color as separate, as enjoying a reality different from this, then the manifestation of the reality as red and as blue and as white is one reality manifesting as all these different colors. If this is how I appreciate, then along with the appreciation of the variety, there is also the appreciation of the unity, then it's okay. But yatha, what is it? Yatha, prusak bhavan, when Lord Krishna describes the rajasam jnanam, sarva bhuteshu yenekam bhavam avyamikshate avibhaktam vibhakteshu tad jnanam vidhi sattvikam prusak tvenudyat bhavan nana bhavan prusak vidhan. But when one sees everything different from everything else and everything different from oneself, then one cannot remain free from comparison and free from judgment. It says you should not judge, but you cannot but judge. Moment there is something different from it, it is boundary judged. Swami, I am non-judgmental. That you may be. Gross judgment you may not have. But the subtle judgment is always there, that this is different from me. I am different from that. And then I can suspend my judgment that is good, bad or indifferent. That will be forcing myself, you know, because the mind has a tendency to come to conclusions. But anyway, moment there is a role, which is such an innocent role. To say that I am just looking at the world sounds innocent, which it is. Still, there is either evident dukkha or potential dukkha. If the world that I perceive, I am a perceiver, if the world that I perceive is something that is not to my liking, not to my satisfaction, immediately creates a reaction. And even if it is to my satisfaction, then it is said, it is going to have a potential problem because someday it may not satisfy me or something else may not satisfy me, the reference to that. So every role has a problem whenever there is identification of the role. Every role is limited. Not a problem but limited. But when there is an identification with the role, then there is a sense of liberation, which is a problem. If the problem which belongs to the role is only attributed to the role, then it's okay. But when the problem that belongs to the role is, however, taken upon the self, then dukkhitvada abhimanaha, then dukkhitvam, sukhitvam, etc., which all belongs to the role, they all belong to the Atma. And the dukkhitvam, sukhitvam comes because I hear something. That's all. It can be a problem. I heard something. If I did not hear, I would have been okay. Ignorance is bliss. If I did not know certain things, I would have been fine. But I heard something. I was upset. I heard something about myself, or I heard something about somebody else. I can get upset. I see something. I wish I had not seen it. I smell something. I wish I had not smelled it. I think there is some dead thing there, you know. If I did not smell, okay. I smell, I can't do anything, you know. We must first get rid of it. Whatever. The idea is that moment the experience takes place in the realm of duality, where what is experienced is taken to be separate from the experiencer, it involves problem. That is samsara. The samsara can be either evidently there, or sometimes it can be potentially there. But there is involved a samsara whenever there is a duality of the perceiver and the perceived. So that's what abhipraya of Yajnavalkya is. Swayabhiprayam vacha dvaitehi rupad vishesha sanyana bandhano dukhitvad abhimanaha. Hey Maitreyi, it's only in the realm of duality that all the abhimana or the conclusion that I am dukhi, sukhi, etc. is there. Ananda jnana ikarasa brahmadvayanubhave tutat kena kampasyet yatravasya sramatma ivabhut tat kenakam jighret kenakam pashet kenakam shrunayat kenakam abhivadet kenakam manvita kenakam vijaniyat. So that explains ananda jnanaikarasa brahmadve anubhave sarvatma ivabhut. What kind of atma? So ananda jnana ekarasa. Brahma is not only ananda but jnanam also. Brahman is satyam, jnanam, anantam or anandam. And so, jnana and ananda should go together, because in the state of deep sleep, the ananda is there but jnanam is not there. And all the time we have jnanam but no ananda also. So in jnana and ananda, both of them are there, that is Brahman. Ananda jnana ikarasa brahma advayanu bhave, that Brahman which is non-dual of the nature of jnanam and ananda, when that is experienced and known as a self, anubhavetu, that can be known only as self. There is no other way of knowing Brahman which is jnana and ananda ekrasam. Kena kampashe brahmava kena vijaniyat. Who will see what with what? Who will know what with what? So how can that Brahman now be seen, smelt, heard? Brahman, when it is known as a self, who can hear him? Who can smell him? Who can think of him? Who can know him? Brahmava kena vijaniyat, vijnataramare kena vijaniyat. And so, yenidam sarvam vijanati, tam kena vijaniyatati. That by which one knows everything, how can one know that? How come Brahma cannot be known? Nahi tada asya karma bhavasti svaprakashatvat. Because now Brahman has reduced itself to Atma, which is Vishaya, which is svaprakasha, self-effulgent, therefore Brahman ceases to be karma or object. As long as there is duality, Brahma remains an object. All of this is Brahma alone, but Brahman alone is looked upon as object. But when everything is known as self, Brahman ceases to be an object. Nahi tada asya karma bhavasti svaprakashatvat. Brahman being self-evident, no more is in the state of karma or object of knowledge. So, etad uktam bhavati, again Bhavadikara explains that. The statement of Yajnavalkya, na sanya matram maya vyasedhi. Hey Maitreyi, when I say na pretya sanyasi, I did not mean that Brahman ceases to be of the nature of consciousness. Brahman becomes unconscious. No. Or Brahman loses consciousness, that is not what I meant. Kintu vishesha sanyayati. That by word sanyaya we should mean vishesha sanya. That Brahman or the wise man also becomes free from now vishesha sanya or that consciousness involving duality. So in fact, what is denied there is a consciousness involving duality and not consciousness per se. Sanya matram na vyasedhi. I did not intend to deny consciousness per se, but I meant to deny on the specific or the particular consciousness which arises because of the duality. Alright, so this is how Bhamadikara explains that whole grantha, you know, the whole Brahmana. Going back there to Bhashya on the same page 330, so Vashyakara said, Nashayetad Aupacharikam Ashrayatum Shakyam Yat Karanam Atma Vijnanina Sar Vijnanam Pradignaya Anantarena Granthena Tadeva Upavadayati, which Upavadam we already seen. So we cannot say, as Purupaksha said, that knowing the Atma, everything becomes known is only said in a figurative way. that it should not be taken literally. Vashikara says, no, there is no reason why it should not be taken literally. Because yat karanat, because yat karanam atmavijnanena sarvijnanam pratijnaya, having made a proposition or pratijna, having made a promise that everything becomes known in the Atma is known, anantarena granthena, by the following text, tadeva upapadayati, that very promise that by knowing the Atma everything becomes known is presented with reasoning, upapadayati. Brahmatam paradat ihanyatra atmaha brahma veda. And so one who knows Brahma or Brahmana is separate from the Atma, as you said, so parada seva margat brahmshayati, that Brahma, that Brahmana actually deviates this fellow from his shreya marga, from the path of his fulfillment. Ityadya. So Bhashyakara himself also obliges to explain this. Let me read that Bhashya, so you repeat that. Yohi brahmakshatradikam jagata atmanah anyatra svatantrena labdha sadbhavam pasyade tam mithyadarshinam tadeva mithyadushtam brahmakshatradikam jagat parakarodi iti bhedadushtim apodya idam sarvam yadayam atma iti sarvasya vastujadasya Atma avyatarekam avatarayati. Yohi brahmakshatradikam jagat atmananyatra veda. Same thing explained, that when one looks upon jagat, so brahma, kshatram, etc. is meant, what is meant is jagat. One looks upon this creation. Atmananyatra veda, meaning what? Svatantrena labdha sadbhavam pasyati. So when one appreciates the jagat as having a satta, sadbhavam, svatantrena labdha sadbhavam pashyati. So when one looks upon jagat as having come into existence independently. So when one looks upon the jagat as having come into existence independently, independent of the self. Meaning when one looks upon the jagat as enjoying a satta or the reality separate from that of the self. Tam mithyadarshan becomes mithyadarshan. The truth of the matter is that everything is Atma alone and still looks upon the jagat as anatma, that is mithya darshanam, false darshanam. Tadeva mithya darshanam, the fellow who thus has his false conclusion. Tadeva mithya dushtam brahmakshatradim jagat, but jagat does not leave him. If I judge the jagat or the creation as different from what it is, then I am paid in kind, you see. That jagat also retaliates. So when I look upon the world as separate from me, the world also retaliates by depriving me from my goal. So tadeva mithya dushtam brahma kshatradikam jagat, that very jagat consisting of brahmana kshatra etc., which is mithya dushtam, which was falsely perceived and judged by this person, tam parakaroti, this mithya darshanam parakaroti. Parakaroti says Ratna Brahma, shreyo margad brahmshayati. Then he is actually deviated or is thrown off from his shreya marga, from his path of self-fulfillment. Iti bheda dushtim apodya. So this way, how brilliantly, you know, the Shruti actually first of all condemns the bheda dushtim and then establishes the abheda. So not only is the abheda established, but bheda is also condemned by saying that bheda is mithya. The reason for condemning bheda is to declare that it is mithya, to make it understand that it is not there and is taken to be there, which means it is mithya. So bheda drishti is declared to be mithya. Bheda drishti mapodhya. Idam sarvam yadayam atma idhi sarvasya vasu jatasya atma vidayakam utarayati. At the end it is said, why is it so? How come this brahmana, kshatriya, etc. do that? So idam kshatram imi lokaha imi devaha imani bhutani idam sarvam yadayam atma. The reason why they treat you like this is because you look upon them as different from what they are. In fact, all is creation consisting of Brahmana, Kshatriya, all of them is nothing but Atma. And when one looks upon that as an Atma, then this is how it retaliates.
Idam sarvam yadayam atma yadi sarvasya vastu jatasya atma vyatirekam avata.
Idam sarvam yadayam atma. All of this is nothing but Atma. In that sense,
vastu jatasya atma vyatirekam avata yadi vastu jatasya.
The entire creation, atma vyatirekam, is non-separate from the Atma, is what is actually introduced and what is shown by the Shruti there.
Then Vashiratna Prabha says, Yatha Dundubishankavina Shabda Samanya Grahaneva Krukhyamanaha Tadavantara Visheshaha Shukti Grahana Grahya Rajadavat Samanya Kalpitaha Patahana Bidyande Ivum Atmabhanasya Ivum Atmabhanabhasyam Sarvam Atmamatramidhi Nischidamityaha Yatha Dundubishankavina Shabda Samanya Grahaneva.
Just by a perception of the hearing, of Shabda Samanya, of the general sound of Dundubhi, Shankha, Veena,
now these instruments,
Tadavandarvisheshaha, Grukhyamanaha, Davandarvisheshaha, the variations of the sound are perceived only when the general sound is perceived.
Shukti, Grahana, Grahya, Rajadavat.
Just as the Rajata that can be perceived only when Shuktika is perceived,
Samanya Kalpitaha, all the Vishesha, the particulars are those which are superimposed upon Samanya. In general,
all the particulars are superimposed upon the universal. And so the universal is the truth, particulars are nothing but the manifestations of that universe,
universal.
Kalpitaha Tatahana Bhidyante.
So just as the particulars are not separate from the universal,
even Atmabhana Bhasyam Sarvam Atma Matramidi.
And similarly, so
Idam Sarvam Yadayam Atma, that is explained by so many examples.
So Atma Vijnanena Sarvam Vididam Syat, by knowing the Atma, everything becomes known, is proved by saying Idam Sarvam Yadayam Atma, all of this is Atma alone.
How is all of this Atma? So that is illustrated by number of examples.
As to how all of this is Atma at the time of sustenance,
all of this is Atma even before creation, all of this is Atma even after dissolution.
Thus it is proven,
Idam Sarvam Yadayam Atma,
all of this is nothing but Atma.
And therefore, Atma is Upadana Karanam,
and therefore, knowing the Atma, everything becomes known.
That's how the Pratijna is fulfilled.
Evam Atmabhana Bhasyam Sarvam Atma Matramidi,
and similarly also, just as the Vishesha cannot be perceived apart from Samanya, and similarly also, the whole universe, which is all variety, consisting of the variety and multiplicity, that cannot be perceived apart from the Atmabhana Bhasyam.
Atmabhana means what?
So all of that is illumined only by the Atma.
And so it is nothing but the Atma alone.
So consciousness of the Atma is always involved in the consciousness of the Jagat.
And therefore the Jagat is not separate from the Atma, there is consciousness.
Idi nischitamityaha dundubhyadi drishtante.
So Bhashyakara says, dundubhyadi drishtante ischa tameva avyatarekam drahati.
So by the illustration of dundubhi, Shankhaveena also,
tameva avyatarekam drahati, that the Jagat is not apart from consciousness, avyatireka.
That Jagat cannot stand apart from consciousness.
And so, dhradayati, that is in fact firmed up by the illustrations, that the Jagat is non-separate from consciousness, is in fact made firm.
Sri Ratna Prabha, ekam evam eka vijnanena sara vijnana prajnayaha mukhyatvad brahma nishyaha.
And therefore, understand,
eka vijnanena sara vijnana pratijna.
That promise that everything is known when one is known is meant in a primary sense, is meant in a literal sense.
Mukhya brahma mukhyatvat brahma nishchayate pratijna is meant.
So Shruti means what it says,
not just in a secondary sense, in a primary sense. And so eka vijnana sarva vijnanam,
the knowledge of everything by knowledge of one is possible only when that one is Brahman.
Therefore brahma nishchaya, therefore also it is clear that Brahma is the subject matter of this Brahmana. sarva srashtutva lingada bhityaha. And by the evidence of the linga that Brahman is the creator of everything, so asya mahataha, says Vashya.
Asya mahato bhutasya nishvasitam etata yadrugvedaha ityadinacha prakutasyatmanaha nam rupa karma prapanchakaranata vyachakshanaha Paramatmanam enam gamayati.
Asya mahato bhutasya nishvasitam etadya drugvedaha ityadinacha prakatasya atmanaha nam rupa krama prapanchakaranatam vyachakshanaha. That's the Shruti. Or it says Yajnavalkya, who is desirous of saying that Brahman is the karanam, the cause of the creation consisting of name and form, by the statement that just as so from the fire all the sparks etc. emerge, and so also from this great reality Rigveda and all this Nam Rupatmakam Jagat emerges, that way also Yajnavalkya, who is desirous of seeing that that Brahman is the creator, that way also Paramatmanam Eva Gamayati, only Paramatma can be the creator in the primary sense and not Jivatma.
So yad etat drugvedaha, say Ratnavara, irugvedadikam nama ishtam so nama rupa krama prapancha karanatam.
Actually, Shruti only talks about rugveda, yajurveda, etc., mantra brahmana. But Vashyakara says nama rupa krama prapancha karanatam vyachakshana. What is meant is that Brahman is the creator of the cause of nama rupa and the karma prapancha. Prapancha consisting of nama rupa karma. But where does the Shruti say? When the nama is said, then rupa is already said.
So rugveda adhikam nama.
And so rugveda yajurveda, so mantra brahmana is a nama. And the rupa automatically is non-separate from nama. And ishtam hutam idhi karma. Ishtam hutam, worship or offered, this is karma.
Ayam chalokaha parash chalokaha idhi rupam. This world and the other world, this is the rupa, the form.
Kincha sayasa sarvasamapam sumudhaika eva ekayanam idhi kandikaya sarvaprapanchasya mukhyalai adharatvatmana brahmatve lingam. And further also, just as the ocean is the adhara or the ashraya, the abode of all the waters, and therefore laya adhara. Samudra is the laya adhara. Samudra is the very locus of the laya, the merger of all the waters. And so also Paramatma is presented as the locus of merger of the entire creation. That becomes another linga. At the time of sustenance, at the time of creation, at the time of merger also. So three lingas.
Sarvaprapanchasya mukhyalaya adharatvam atmanah brahmatve lingam, and therefore sarvaprapanchasya, the entire prapancha, is mukhyalaya adharatvam, and so brahma, that atma is mukhyalaya adhara, also says that atma is brahma alone there.
So tatheva, says Bhashya,
tatheva ekayana prakriyayamape savishasya sendriyasya santahkaranasya prapanchasya ekayanam anantaram abahyam krishnam prajnanagharam vyachakshanah paramatmanam enam gamayati.
Tathaiva, similarly also ekayana prakriyayamapi, that kandika, 12th kandika, which talks of this ekayanam, how everything merges into one. Savishasya, vishaya are mentioned, sendriya, sindriya are mentioned, santahkana, santahkana is mentioned, prapanchasya. So prapancha consisting of the sense objects, sense organs, mind, etc. Ekayanam, that it is one ayanam. What is anantaram, avahyam, krishnam, prajnanaghanam? Prajnanam is actually vijnanaghanam. And so, ekayanam, the entire prapancha has its ayanam, the abode in one Brahman. Anantaram, avahyam, which doesn't have inside, doesn't have outside, doesn't have cause, doesn't have effect. Krishnam, which is totality. Prajnanaghanam, which is the nature of mass of consciousness, pure consciousness. Vyachakshanaha, paramatmanamenam gamayati. So when that linga also, gamayati, it also actually only leads us to the the understanding that Atma is nothing but Brahman or Paramatma.
Siddhi Utpatti Layoktya Alochanadaha Siddhu Upasamharati, and that is how when we see the whole Brahmana, which talks about the non-separateness of the creation at the time of Siddhi, Utpatti and Pralaya. So what is the conclusion? Tasmad, Bhashyakara says, Tasmad Paramatmanah Eva Ayam Darshanadi Upadeshah Iti Gamyate.
Tasmad, therefore, Paramatma Eva Ayam Darshanadi Upadeshah Atmavara Drashtavya Shrutavya Mantavya. What is meant by Atma there? Paramatma. So, Paramatma Evayam Darshanadi Upadesha. This Darshanadi Upadesha. Upadesha, the instruction. Drashtavya, Shrutavya, Mantavya, Nivnyasavya. Atma Vijnanena Saram Viditam Syat. That also. Tani, so, Etebhya, Bhutebhya, Samuttaya. That also. All of this is what is meant in every, in all these places is nothing but Paramatma alone. So, Paramatma Evayam Darshanadi Upadesha Hidi Gamyate. It is quite clear when we look at this linga or the evidences that this is the Upadesha of Paramatma and not Atma. Okay, good.
Om Purnamadav Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyade Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Veda Vibhagine
Yoma Vandhyatta
Nihaya Dakshina Murtaye Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namah Hari Om.
So Vakyan Vyad Paramatma Upadesha Evayam. That in the Maitri Brahmana, the subject matter is Paramatma and not Jivatma. Vakyan Vyad, because of the Anvaya, the correlation of the whole passage. Vakyam Hidam Paura Pariyena Avekshamanam Paramatmanam Prati Anvitavayam Lakshate Anjad Durkaran Avastavayam. This is the second bit. Asvinashasti Vittenaiti Yajnaval Kyadu Pashrutya. This is how the discussion started, that by Vitta or the Karma, the immortality cannot be attained. And so Maitreyi, who was desirous of only immortality, to her this was told, Atma Vijnanam Idam Upadishati Yajnivalkya. To Maitreyi, who was desirous of immortality, Yajnivalkya imparted this knowledge of the Self. And therefore, that Atma Vijnanam, the knowledge of the Self that was imparted in response to the request of Maitreyi for immortality, shows that the Atma was Paramatma and not Jivatma. Nachanyatra Paramatma Vijnanad Amrutatvasti. It cannot be that one can attain immortality by knowledge of anything other than Paramatma, and therefore the Atma Jnanam that Yajnavalkya imparted to Maitri must be that of Paramatma. Tathacha Atma Vijnanena Sarvijnana Uchyamanam. 2-1 is that this was a teaching imparted in response to the request for means of immortality. Secondly, Atma Vijnanena Sarvijnana Uchyamanam, that by the knowledge of Atma that everything becomes known. This is what was said. Nanyatra paramakarana vijnanad mukhyam avakalpade. And there also that Atma, the knowledge of whom is a means or knowledge of which is the knowledge of everything, that Atma must be the Paramakaranam, the ultimate cause of the creation, because otherwise by the knowledge of one, everything can be known, that cannot happen. So number one, that this Atmajnanam is in response to the request of the means of immortality. Secondly, this Atmajnanam is a means for knowledge of everything. And therefore, we say that this is the Atma is Paramatma and not Jivatma. Further also, that there is the Ninda of the Dvaita. Brahmatam Paradat Ihanyatra Atmaha Brahma Veda. So one who takes Atma, Brahma, Brahmana to be different from the Self is condemned or is rejected by that Brahmana, whoever it is. Idam Sarvam Yadayam Atma, and all of this is indeed Atma, and therefore everything is Atma. So which Atma it is? The Atma of which, from which the Jagat is not a part at the time of sustenance. Atma from which Jagat is not a part at the time of creation. Atma from which Jagat is not a part at the time of dissolution, and therefore also that Atma must be Paramatma. So Dundubhyadi Dushtantehi, by Dushtanta Dundubhi and Shankha and the Veena, it was said how at the time of sustenance the whole creation is nothing but consciousness, because nothing can be perceived apart from consciousness, just as the general sounds cannot be perceived or known or heard apart from the particular sound cannot be heard apart from the general sound, and so also no names and forms can be known apart from consciousness, and therefore this universe is nothing but consciousness at the time of sustenance. Asya mahato bhutasya nishvasitam yada yada drugvedaha. Then at the time of creation also, so Brahma Paramatma is the creator, just as so Rugveda is the nama and the rupa, so the whole creation of names and forms, just as the sparks etc. emerge from the fire effortlessly, and so also the whole creation of names and forms emerges from Paramatma, and then he is a creator.
Nama rupa karma prapancha karanadam vyasakshanaha paramatmanam eva gamayati enam gamayati.
And that's when Atma is presented as that which is the cause of the entire creation of name and form, that must be also Paramatma. And again, he is also presented as the Laya Ashraya, the very abode of Laya, the locus of Laya, or the dissolution of the entire creation.
Savishasya, Sendriyasya, Santahkaranasya, Prapanchasya, Ekayanam, Anantaram Abhakyam, Krishnam Prajnanagram Vyatakshanaha.
Savishasya, the entire creation, including all the sense organs or sense objects, Sendriyasya, all the sense organs, Santahkaranasya, the mind, so the entire growth in the subtle creation.
Prapanchasya Ekayanam,
there is one abode at the time of dissolution, and there is which one is that?
Anantaram Abhakyam, Krishnam Prajnanagram.
Anantaram Abhakyam, that is devoid of inside, outside, or any limitations, which is Prajnanagram, which is the mass of consciousness.
Paramatmanam enam gamayati,
all of these are the gamakas. So, Bhashyakara presents here from the Maitreya Brahmana all the gamaka, all the signs leading to the conclusion that the subject matter here is Paramatma.
Tasmat Paramatma vayam darshanadi upadesha iti gamyate.
And then Atma vare dashtavyaha, shrutavyaha, mantavyaha, nididhyasatavyaha. Which Atma is that? That must be Paramatma.
Tasmat Paramatmahe vayam darshanadi upadesha.
Therefore this upadesha, the instruction, dashtavyaha, shrutavyaha, the one that is presented as that which should be realized and listened to and reflected upon and meditated upon, it must be Paramatma. Now, page 331 says Bhamadikara Tadevam Paurya Paryalochanaya Maitreyi Brahmanasya Brahma Darshana Paratve Sthite Paurya Paryalochanaya. Thus when you do the alochanam of what is preceded, what follows, and when we look at the entire teaching of Maitreyi Brahmana, Brahma Darshana Paratve Sthite, it is concluded, or with reasonable arguments it is concluded that it teaches actually Brahma Darshanam. भोक्त्रा जीवात्मना उपक्रमम आचार्य देशीय मतेन तावत् समाधत्ते सूत्रकार है. द क्वेश्चन इज इफ ब्रह्म इज द सब्जेक्ट मैटर ऑफ मैत्री ब्रह्म हाउ कम द डिस्कशन कमेंसेस विथ द मेंशन ऑफ भोक्ता द जीवात्मा आत्मनस्तु कामाय सर्वं प्रियं भवति. एवरीथिंग इज डियर बिकॉज द आत्मा इज डियर. सो आत्मा इज ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ लव and everyone knows that the atma is a jivatma and it is for the sake of the jivatma that everything is dear or everything is an object of enjoyment of the jivatma. So how come the upakrama, the commencement of the teaching, is made with jivatma? Why is it so? So different acharyas had explained this in their own way. Acharya deshiya matena tavat samadhatte sutrakara. Sutrakara gives samadhanam as to why the discussion begins with jivatma or with bhokta. What appears to bhokta is also the argument of the Purvapakshi. Priyasam suchidena atmana bhokta upakrama. Because the discussion commences with the atma who is bhokta, who is indicated as the object of love and for whom the entire creation is the object of enjoyment. So how come the commencement is made that way? So different acharyas give explanation depending upon their own understanding of why this Maitri Brahmana commences that way. Acharya Deshiya Mataya. All of them are Vedantins, all right, but then not quite Advaita Vedantins. And therefore they give explanations which are not quite in keeping with our own perception. However, so these next two sutras present two alternative explanations which almost form Purvapaksha, wherein which there the Siddhanta then is provided by the third sutra. This is the Trisutri, the three sutras are there. Or Sutra Trayi rather, three sutras are there. So the Sutra 20 says here, Pratijna Siddhehe Lingam Ashmaratyaha. So Ashmaratyaha, that's the name of an acharya. What does he have to say? Pratijna Siddhehe. Eka vijnanena sarvijnanam bhavati iti pratijna. That by the knowledge of the Atma that everything becomes known, that pratijna has been made by Shruti, by the sage Yajnavalkya. Siddhehe, in order to accomplish or fulfill that promise. Lingam, so abhedam shamadaya jiva upakramanam lingam. That the argument, the discussion begins with the jivatma apparently or bhokta is because the teacher wants to fulfill the promise that by knowing one everything becomes known. This is what Achari Ashmaratya believes. What his opinion is, that he doesn't accept the total non-duality or one total identity between Jiva and Brahma, but he seems to accept some kind of a relationship between them of Karya and Karana. So Karya Karana. Says Bhamadikara here, Yathai vannehe vikaraha vicharantaha visvalingaha na vannehe atyantam bhidyante. Yathā vannehe vikārāha vicharantaḥ. Just as the vikārāha, the modifications of fire, visphulingāha, the sparks which emerge from the fire and modification of fire. That's one way of looking at them. What's the relationship between fire and the sparks? So sparks emerge from the fire. Something similar is looked upon as a relationship between jīva and brahma because this illustration is provided by the Shruti herself. Navannehe atyandam vidyande. You cannot say the sparks are totally different from fire. Tadrupanirupanatvat. Because actually when you analyze the nature of spark, then you realize that its true nature is nothing but fire, heat and light. Therefore we cannot say that these sparks are totally different from fire. Navitadah atyandam abhinnaha. Nor can we say the sparks are totally non-different from the fire. Because you won't call them sparks. Vandeheva paraspara vyavrutti abhava prasangat. See, what is the relationship between fire and fire? There is no relationship. There is no paraspara vyavritti. One does not displace the other. The idea of the fire does not displace the idea of fire because the ideas are one. However, when in your mind there is idea of spark, that displaces the idea of fire. When you utter the word fire, it creates an idea. And when we utter the word fire, it creates another idea. And this idea of the spark displaces the idea of fire. This paraspara vyavritti. One displacing the other. Then we say that two things are different. Like horse and buffalo. So idea of horse displaces the idea of buffalo and vice versa. Then we say that they are totally different from each other. Where that does not happen, we say that they are not totally different. Like the idea of the ornament does not displace the idea of gold. Therefore, we would not say that the ornament is totally different from the gold. However, they say that we have to accept some kind of difference in gold and ornament. Because otherwise, we would not call it ornament. The fact that we call it ornament has a different, has a form, has a particular use and a function to perform. Therefore, you accept some kind of difference between them. So therefore, just as between the spark and the fire, there is non-difference in as much as both of them have the nature of light and heat. At the same time, there is a difference between them because one is called fire, other is called spark. Tatha jivatmano abhi brahma vikaraha na brahmanahatyandam vidyande chidrupatva bhava prasangaha.